welcome to the Poetry of Little Things. I'm Irina, and today I want to explore with you and contemplate on power. The way I mean power is that personal expression that we have, our unique expression that could make a difference in the world. And how do we bring that out into the world? How do we seek that inside ourselves? I personally am in a very challenging process of redefining what that means for me and how can I express that more into my life. And yesterday for me that meant going deeply inside my body into that place where I feel completely powerless and I just can't move. So I just couldn't move the whole of yesterday, whereas I have so many plans of how to take this poetry project onward and how can I work in a way that serves my creative potential and thus serving the world. It's a very frightening process because it's uncharted. I have no benchmark. I know the way my parents did it and the way it's being done in this culture where I live. But other than that, it's just uncharted territory that makes me so afraid that on some days I just cannot get up. I can't move my body. So the gift for me in this time of my life is to be able to sit at home and just see how that feels, because I'm so used to doing, always being in action and snapping myself out of the process. And on reaching out through the means of this channel, through poetry, people have reached back to me saying, hey, I know what you're going through. I'm going through the same thing and I feel so scared. So it's nice to know that we are not alone. And a few days ago, a dear friend of mine that is going through a very similar process of owning her power shared this poem with me by poet and philosopher, Irish poet and philosopher John O'Donohue, whom I love very much. And it's a blessing. It's a blessing for one who holds power. And today I want to share this poem for my friend Cecilia and for another beautiful friend of mine, Irina, who is also named Irina and is on her way today embarking in a new journey in her life in Sweden. And also to myself. I want to offer this poem to myself, to the part of me that is so scared that on some days it just can't move. And I want to offer this poem as a soothing prayer that it is actually safe to go out into the world and share ourselves. And to all of you that are watching this and maybe go through a similar process. So, here it is. A Blessing for the One Who Holds Power by John O'Donohue. Deep breath. May the gift of leadership awaken in you as a vocation. Keep you mindful of the providence that calls you to serve. As high over the mountains, the eagle spreads its wings. May your perspective be larger than the view from the foothills. When the way is flat and dull in times of gray endurance, may your imagination continue to evoke horizons. When thirst burns in times of drought, may you be blessed to find the wells. May you have the wisdom to read time clearly and know when the seed of change will flourish. In your heart, may there be a sanctuary for the stillness where clarity is born. May your work be infused with passion and creativity, and have the wisdom to balance compassion and challenge. May your soul find the graciousness to rise above the fester of small mediocrities. May your power never become a shell wherein your heart would silently atrophy May you welcome your own vulnerability as the ground where healing and truth join. May integrity of soul be your first ideal, the source that will guide and bless your work. Thank you for watching this, and may you find your own prayer to silently whisper to yourself from your heart on your days of grey endurance, and may you sense when the time is right that your gifts are ripe and you are ready to overcome the great fear of the unknown and step outside of your comfort zone and do the bravest thing you'll ever do. Softness to your day.